Hey everybody, and welcome to the shop. My name is Jameson, and today I'm going to be walking you through the setup and test run of the G1026 3 horsepower shaper. Let's get started. Inside the crate, you'll find the shaper, the magnetic switch, and the forward and reverse switch. With everything uncrated, we're looking really good. Now the remaining boxes are inside, so let's undo the back panel. This box that's connected to the motor has your magnetic switch and your forward and reverse switch. So we're gonna unbox this, place it back inside, and close up the rear of the machine. Everything's inventoried and looking really good, and now it's time for some cleanup. We're gonna start here. The unpainted surfaces of your machine are coated with a heavy-duty rust preventative for shipping, and it can take a little bit of time to remove. You want to avoid harsh solvents like acetone or brake part cleaner when removing this coating, as it can damage painted surfaces. You even want to make sure that you get in and actually clean out the spindle housing and the inserts. With all the unpainted surfaces looking really nice and clean, it's time to consider where to place this machine. So for this, I'm gonna flip things around and then look around my shop to determine where I have good clearance for infeed and outfeed for something like trim molding. Being close to the proper plug, which in this case is a 615 220 volt plug-in, is essential. Now you can have an extension cord for a machine this size, but you do want to keep that extension cord to a minimum size if possible to reduce voltage drop over distance. Another consideration is having about 30 inches from a wall to the back of the machine. That gives you plenty of clearance to work behind the machine. With the machine on the ground, it's time to start assembly. So let's begin by removing this motor cover. Inside, you're gonna find two shipping braces, and you wanna make sure you keep the hex bolt, hex nut, and flat washer from each, but remove the red items. Reinstall the fasteners removed earlier. Remove the grommet plate, forward reverse switch, and magnetic switch from the cabinet, then reinstall the motor cover. Install the grommet plate to the motor cover using the screws and nuts that were already mounted. Next, install the forward and reverse to the cabinet using the pre-mounted screws. Directly above the forward reverse switch is the magnetic switch mounting location. Connect the switch with the pre-mounted screws as well. On the front of the machine, install the hand wheel onto the hand wheel shaft. Then tighten the set screw on the back side onto the flat spot of the hand wheel shaft. Next, it's time to set up the spindle. Now I have a 3/4 inch spindle right here and the drawbar. The drawbar has threads on each end and a tapered nut. So you're gonna want to remove that and then insert it into the bottom of the spindle. Rotate the drawbar 10 to 15 times to seat it properly. Place the assembly into the spindle cartridge here, making sure to align the keyway in the bottom of the spindle with the pin in the spindle cartridge. Use the included spindle wrench on top and an open-ended wrench below the table and snug the drawbar nut. I say snug because you want it tight, but not excessively tight. If that makes sense. With the spindle in place, let's move on to the table inserts. The machine comes with 3 insert sizes, giving you 4 possible opening diameters on the table, depending on the size of cutter you plan to use. There are 2 aluminum inserts and 1 cast iron insert. The cast iron insert must be flush with the top of the table, and you could check and adjust that using a simple straight edge and a flathead screwdriver to level the insert all around. With the insert installed and everything leveled up, it's time to move on to the extension wing. Start by removing the pre-installed hardware and then ensure that the mating surface is nice and smooth, both here and on the extension wing itself. Install the wing starting on one side by reusing the hardware that you removed a moment ago and work your way across. Remember to keep them a little loose so we can adjust the height. Once all the bolts are inserted, go back and forth and flush the top surface. Use a straight edge to check the table flatness. If the table tilts up or down slightly on the end, you can actually use masking tape as a shim. The final bolt and table section may need a little bit of clamping force or a rubber mallet to get it to align perfectly, but don't worry, this is totally normal. Table's installed, ready to go. Time to put the fence on. Now it's time to put together the guard assembly. To do that, well, follow this diagram. And while you're doing that, I'm gonna put this one together. Once the guard is assembled, mount it directly to the table, as shown here. It's always really important to adjust the safety guard height with each workpiece and to get as close to the cutting area as possible without interfering with the workpiece or any jigs or fixtures. You can also install the hold downs that are included as shown here to properly press down on the workpiece and keep it tight to the fence. These are great general purpose hold downs and install quickly. The next step before test run is if you have the optional 3-inch dust port is to connect that to the back side of the fence, and then we're on to the test run. We recommend having a minimum of 400 CFM for dust collection for a shaper, and we do have a huge selection of dust ports and collection fittings and hoses on grizzly.com. With that installed, it's time to get on to the test run. Connect the machine to power and turn the forward reverse switch to the forward position. Then press the on button. Let the motor start up completely, then press the off button. Next, rotate the switch to the reverse position. Then turn the machine on. Let the motor start up completely, then press the off button. And that's it. We've inventoried, placed the machine, assembled it, and done a test run of your new shaper. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and stay tuned for more videos like this from Grizzly Industrial.